like something out of a novel, federal prosecutors say beginning in 2005, Jonathan Arrington, Mike Kratville, and Mike Wilkie promoted the first version of their business, Elite Management, as a way to invest in a non-traditional way, promising to invest no more than 10% of their clients' money at any one time to reduce risk, putting their investors in a financial comfort zone. Prosecutors say the men touted their extensive skills in trading futures, market analysis, and successful investment strategies. One of the men going as far as saying he was friends with Warren Buffett and that Buffett's children were some of Elite Management's investors too. Prosecutors say that claim and others were false. Turns out Arrington, Kratville, and Wilkie have faced these allegations before. In a 2011 civil suit from the U.S. Commodity Futures Trading Commission, the agency offered a little more detail about what happened to the money, saying the men used, at a minimum, more than $700,000 to pay for golf club memberships, travel, and dining, and used more than $850,000 to make Ponzi payments, or in other words, take money from new investors to pay off old ones. If that's not enough, prosecutors say that Nebraska's Department of Banking and Finance questioned Elite Management's operation and asked Arrington, Kratville, and Wilkie to shut it down. The men did, but prosecutors say without Nebraska's knowledge, the men opted to continue their fraudulent scheme under different company names based in Wyoming.